Hi, hello, this is Charlie Jose. You're watching another episode of Upstream Charlie. In today's episode, let's not dilly-dally. I'm gonna do a how-to video about Metamask, because Metamask has lately changed their interface and you should get to know the interface of the Metamask in case you want to use Metamask in the near future, or if you're just starting in crypto. So Metamask is the number one crypto wallet, and the others you could choose as well, depending on what security level you're into. But everybody starts with Metamask. Okay, so this is the interface of Metamask. Once you've downloaded it, it's available in iOS and in Android, of course, Android, iOS. Okay, so you could see here, there's a logo on the left side, and this one in the middle is the selection of network. You could also add network later, we'll discuss that. And on the other one is you could scan, if you want to be sending a token or a coin to another wallet. Okay, and this one is your account section plus the corresponding address. So per account there's a different address. Okay, in here I have inputted several accounts. If you want to add accounts, click the add accounts and add new accounts, or import accounts, or add hardware wallets. Okay, and if you want to copy this, you could like select this one, and you could edit the the three one is basically setup. You just select edit. If you want to change the edit the account name, you want to use your name, it's okay. Then the other one, you could view it on BS scan and share my public address and show private keys. Okay, so that's the three buttons. And if you want to swap accounts, you could do so like that, and it will go to your second account or third, and then your address here you could like copy. And if you want somebody to deposit something into your account, make sure you are in the same chain if you are depositing or withdrawing coins or tokens into your account. So if you have money in Polygon, you go to Polygon. If you have, so you're in the Polygon network, in your Polygon wallet, of the same wallet address of account number one. Same thing if you're in Arbitrum. In Arbitrum, of course, you need to buy ETH, and then you need to have an ETH Arbitrum, because they use ETH as gas, not ARB tokens to use the gas, unfortunately. So let's go back to the NB chain. Sorry, I'm munching candy because my throat is itchy. And what else? So yeah, I'm on the BNB smart chain now. Thank you. Wow. And of course, you also have the NFTs. You could put your NFTs here, but I used to have NFTs here. Now it's gone. I don't know why. Maybe if you cannot see it, just import it again. Make sure you have the addresses of your NFTs if you're using the BNB chain NFTs. So there, if you scroll down, you could add one new token found in this account. What is that? What is this? No, hide all. So if you're not familiar, with a token, it might be a poison token, you know, be careful. So if you want to import tokens, you could import it like that. Oh, wait. Okay. Let's say if you want to hide this, you could hide that. And if I want to import tokens, you could do search. And let's say BTCB. And then click on that, highlight that, go to import. And then it's going to import your BTCB or BNB chain Bitcoin. So there. So what else? So if you want to import tokens, if it's not in the list, you need to go to custom, and then you have to type in the token address, token symbol, and token decimal point. You could do that when you search on the web, you know, type in let's say Matic, or let's say a coin, let's say Caspa coin address, and then you'll get those address and data, so you could copy it and paste it here in your wallet and import it. And what else? Okay, that'll be good. If you want to send and receive tokens, you click on the token that you want to send and receive, buy or swap. So if you want to receive, you'll have the receive image here, or you could copy the address. So you could receive your BNB coin from your sender. You could also buy BNB. Here. And you have different kind of payment methods that's available. See, you could do GCash. Oh, they could do GCash already. Google Pay, Grab Pay, Shopee Pay. Oh, it's already incorporated. Wow. So if you do GCash, is it available? Go to GCash. Okay. Or you just follow it, and then you could buy coins here in MetaMask. Oh, that's an improvement. Before, it was like just credit card. See, or you could do just credit card and debit card. Now they have incorporated, you know, Union Bank, BPI, Shopee Pay, GrabPay, Maya, and GCash. Oh, that's good. If that's the case, better use Union Bank. And let's say you want to, let's say USDT, and then you want to have an amount of, let's say 6,000 pesos, and then you get quotes, and then you pay using your Union Bank. Nice. Okay. So let's go back to the main menu because I'm not gonna buy. If you wanna swap, start swapping. Okay, you could swap here. They're gonna just get the best price of BNB, and you need to select a token. Let's say USDT. Let's say you want to swap 0.001. Get quotes. There, you'll get 24 cents out of the 0.001 BNB. Okay, and then that is your exchange rate. 1 BNB equals 241.72 in USDT. And then you got the gas fees, etc., all there. And then if you agree, just swipe to swap. And if you want to watch, read the terms of service, you could do so. But we're gonna cancel this because we're not gonna swap. I'm just showing it to you how to swap it within MetaMask. And please note of the max slippage 2%. That's a big. Can you adjust it? Yeah, you could adjust the slippage to 1% if the system allows you. Okay, so be mindful of that. Okay, so let's go back. Let's cancel the swap. Mm-hmm. Watch these three buttons. You could check on the Block Explorer. So that's the BS scan. And you could check if the coin is legit. Okay. There, what else? If you want to add networks, you could go to a website like this one, Chainlist, you know, and then add it to your MetaMask. It's good also if you have a MetaMask extension, so you could add it automatically in your wallet. So there. So if you want to remove that, you could remove it also. So I need to Polygon POS and then Binance Smart Chain. Okay. Okay, yeah, so you could go here, chainlist.org, or if you want to do it manually, like here in the customs page. So from popular, you click on custom networks, get encode this, fill up the blanks, and you could do this. Polygon network name, RPC ID, current symbol, and then block Explorer. Okay, so yeah, here, copy that, paste it. Okay, you could do your search using your web browser in your mobile phone. Okay, and then copy paste it, and then you could just add. Okay, so that's how you're gonna add your networks. What else? So this one is web 3. So you could go to Trader Joe or whatever is available. You know, you could connect to your wallet from here and interact with DEXs. Okay. So I'm not gonna go through this, but I do have several hundred of dollars in PancakeSwap, and you could add new tabs. You know, this is a web browser, so you could add new tabs, and you could like put in Joe or Uniswap or whatever. And what else? And if you click this home, there, this is the home for the, and then you could select the decentralized finance. I don't know if they have updated this. Or decentralized exchanges, 1 inch. Uniswap, let's say you want to go to 1 inch. So 1 inch is basically, I think they're into polygon. There you could go to 1 inch. Takes a while. Yeah, I agree to use the damn cookies. So basically that's it. And then you could explore your DEX from within the MetaMask browser section, internet browser. So last but not the least, let's check on the setups. This will take a while. We're already 15 minutes. So we got general. In general, you could swap your coins here using your national country's coin. Me, I prefer using US dollars. And then just click on native. Then, of course, me, English, although I could use Filipino because I'm Filipino. I'm not Spanish, French, or Hindi, or Japanese, or Korean. So I'm not German or Greek. So English will do. Then you could select from DuckDuckGo and Google to do your search engine. Then hide tokens without balance. So it's your choice. Then here, account identicon. Basically, if you check that, and if you go to the wallet, the account here will change the sort of an icon, or you check block is here, and then you go back. So it has been changed. Okay, and back to general. We're done with general, and then security, privacy, protect your wallet. If you want to check your recovery phrase, make sure you have your password, etc. Then you could also change your passwords. Then you got auto lock, so that you know, in case somebody steals your phone, it locks after 30 seconds. If you're not doodling with the interface, then remember me. Show private key for account one if you want. And privacy. And then clear privacy data, clear browser history, clear browser cookies, participate in metametrics. Basically, they send in data if you have encountered error, etc., or your usage. Then delete metametrics data, delete wallet, batch account balance, get incoming transaction, automatic security checks, checking for updates, may exposure. IP address is using MetaMask. No other information is exposed. There. So that's the security and privacy. If you go to advanced, you could reset your account. This action will clear your transaction activities. This data might not be irretrievable. Okay. Then some IPFS gateway, show hex data, each sign request, customize transaction, nonce, enhanced token detection, state logs. Okay. This will help MetaMask debug any issues you might encounter. Please send it to MetaMask support via hamburger icon, blah, 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 blah. So you could do that yourself. Then contacts, then networks, skip on contacts. Then networks, this is my list of networks, and from here you could add networks as well. And there's also buy crypto. We've seen that earlier. If you click a coin, then experimental. And then about MetaMask. And then contact support if you want. If there's support, I don't know if they have improved their customer service. So basically, that's it for MetaMask. And I'm on my 20 minutes. Wow, very long. But anyway, you've seen the new interface of MetaMask, the insides and outs. And most of you who are in crypto, who are new, most likely you will use MetaMask. So good thing you're watching this video. I know the end part is a little bit boring, but you need to see the interface for yourself if you're about to download the MetaMask. So just repeat the video again and again until you are comfortable or master the MetaMask mobile app. Okay, it's no different from the Google or web extension app of MetaMask. Okay, and they sync together when it comes to networks and I think also in coins. Okay, so that's it for today. Thank you very much for watching. Just bookmark this. So if you want to research again MetaMask in the future, just bookmark it and watch it again and again. Okay, so that's it for now. See you on my next video. Goodbye. Adios. Arrivederci.